فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
سبع من الصحب فوق الألف قد نقلوا من الحديث عن المختار خير مضر أبو هريرة سعد جابر أنس صديقة وابن عباس كذا ابن عمر. Seven من الصحب from the Prophet's companions فوق الألف, more over 1,000 narrations قد نقلوا, they transmitted to us more than 1,000 narrations. من الحديث عن المختار, from the messenger, خير مضر, the Prophet ﷺ is the best of the people of مضر. مضر are the people he's from, عليه الصلاة والسلام, his tribe. Who are the seven? أبو هريرة, سعد, جابر, أنس, صديقة, يعني عائشة, وابن عباس كذا ابن عمر. The seven are, number one, أبو هريرة. Abu Huraira narrated exactly 5,374 narrations. 5,374 narrations alone. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The second one is Abdullah ibn Umar. Abdullah ibn Umar narrated 2,630 narrations. Abdullah ibn Umar. He narrated 2,630 narrations. The next one, the third one, is Anas ibn Malik. Anas ibn Malik narrated 2,286 narrations. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she narrated 2,210. Number five is Abdullah ibn Abbas. He narrated 1,660. Number six is Jabir ibn Abdullah. Jabir ibn Abdullah narrated 1,540. 1,540. Last but not least, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. He narrated 1,170 narrations. 1,170 narrations. So this line of poetry, سَبْعٌ مِنَ الصَّحْبِ فَوْقَ الْأَلْفِ قَدْ نَقَلُوا مِنَ الْحَدِيثِ عَلِي الْمُخْتَارِ خَيْرِ مُضَرْ أبو هريرة سعد جابر أنس صديقة يعني عائشة وابن عباس كذا ابن عمر. So Ibn Abbas is from the Mukthireen, those who've narrated a lot from the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. He said, Ibn Abbas said, جميع العلم, all of knowledge, في القرآن لكن, this is a line of poetry that's attributed to Ibn Abbas. He said, جميع العلم, all of knowledge, is in what? في القرآن لكن. All of knowledge is in the Quran. لكن, but, تقاصروا عنه أفهام الرجال. The people's understanding has become short. Here what happened is meant to be تتقاصروا. And in the Arabic language, this is called حَذْفُ إِحْدَ التَّائَيْنِ. One of the tats are being removed here right now. It's meant to be أَيْ تَتَقَاصَرُ عَنْهُ أَفْهَامُ الرِّجَالِ. All of knowledge is in the Qur'an, but our understanding has fallen short. نعم.
وَمَا أَحْسَنَ قَوْلُ عِيَّةِ.
That statement, sorry, Ibn Abbas, is بَحْرُ وَافِر. It's a بَحْرُ وَافِر. According to the عروض القوافي, in the rhythm and the form it's going now.
وما أحسن قول عياد اليحصبي في كتابه المع العلم في الأصلين لا يعدوهما إلا المضل عن الطريق اللاحب علم الكتاب وعلم الأثار التي قد أسندت عن تابي عن ساحبي.
The author said, وما أحسن what is more greater. وما أحسن what is more greater. قول عياض. The statement of who عياض. Who is he عياض? القاضي عياض اليحسبي. This is القاضي عياض. The great Maliki scholar. Is من أئمة المالكية. And he has a sharh al-sahih Muslim. And he has a book called Masharik al-Anwar. في صحاح الآثار. Masharik al-Anwar. في صحاح الآثار. Where he talks about narrations, hadiths which have in it. He explains the gharaib and the alfaz that are in it, which are somehow hard. This book of his, the author says, وَمَا أَحْسَنَ قَوْلَ عِيَاضٍ الْيَحْسُبِيُّ. What is greater than the statement of who? This ma here is مِنْ بَابِ التَّعَجُّبِ. It's amazed. What's greater? Wow. What is more greater? The statement of who? The statement of قاضي العياض. قاضي العياض. في كتابه, in his book. Is called Al-Ilma'. The long, lengthy name of the book is called Al-Ilma' ila ma'rifati usul al-riwayati wa taqyid al-sima'. That's what the book is called. Al-Ilma' ila ma'rifati al-riwayati wa taqyid al-sima'. Usul al-riwayah, na'am. The line of poetry that is attributed to him, this is, by the way, is Bahru Kamil. He says, العلم في الأصلين لا يعدوهما. العلم, knowledge, is in two things. Knowledge is in two things. Nothing else can take its place. And nothing else. إلا المضل عن الطريق اللاحب. Except the one who is what? Who is misguided from the path that is clear. Lahib means clear. عِلْمُ الْكِتَابِ. The knowledge of what? The knowledge of the kitab. وَعِلْمُ الْآثَارِ. We don't say وَعِلْمُ الْآثَارِ. We say وَعِلْمُ الْآثَارِ when we read it. This Hamza, which is Harakatul Nakhli, has been removed, and it is not وليس للضرورة الشعرية. It's not because of the necessity of the poetry. Sometimes the scholars, they break principles because of the poetry. That's not the case. But rather, it's a lughatu min lughat al-Arab. It's a lugha from the lughat of the Arabs, and sometimes the Quran is read like that. Qira'at, some of the Qira'at, that's how they read it. وَعِلْمُ الْآثَارِ التي, the علم الآثار here is what we mentioned, is what attributed to the Sahabas and the Tabi'in. We took in نخبة الفكر. قد أسندت عن تابعين عن صاحبين. That آثار which is attributed to a Tabi'i from a Sahabi. نعم. So that's what all knowledge is. Knowledge is قال الله قال الرسول. And that which the Sahabas and the Tabi'in said.
وأعلى الهمم في طلب العلم كما قال ابن قيم في كتابه الفوائد طلب علم الكتاب والسنة والفهم عن الله ورسوله نفس المراد وعلم حدود المنزل.
This statement is very, very powerful, and I advise each and every one of you to memorize this line of Ibn al-Qayyim in his Kitab al-Fawaid. Try to memorize it. The author talks about the issue which is known as the aspiration of a student of knowledge. You want to learn knowledge. What should be your himma? What should be your drive whilst learning? He says, وَأَعْلَى الْهِمَمُ فِي طَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ كَمَا قَالَ ابْنُ الْقَيِّمِ فِي كِتَابِهِ الْفَوَائِدِ. As Ibn al-Qayyim said in his book Al-Fawaid. This is a small one volume book. This book Al-Fawaid, are you with me? Is not the Bada'i Al-Fawaid. There's also another book called Fawaid that's also attributed to Ibn al-Qayyim, which is not his book. Scholars have explained and it's proven that's not his book. But the one we have today which is Kitab al-Fawaid, the one we have today, which Dar ibn al-Jawzi published, is very beneficial for a student of knowledge to try to read. It's full of benefits. This statement is so small, but subhanallah, it is little that a person you find today that hasn't somehow fallen into this. And that is, he says, طَلَبُ عِلْمِ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ, seeking the knowledge of the Kitab and the Sunnah, وَالْفَهْمُ عَنِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ نَفْسَ الْمُرَادِ, and also understanding what Allah and His Messenger intend by this. وَعِلْمُ حُدُودِ الْمُنَزَّلِ, and the knowledge of the hudud al-munazzal, the ahkam. Let's look at Ibn al-Qayyim's statement. Ibn al-Qayyim here is talking about the aspiration that a person should have, your ultimate goal in seeking knowledge. Isn't that what the chapter is about? The author brings the statement of Ibn al-Qayyim that the seeking of knowledge, your ultimate goal should be what? طَلَبُ عِلْمِ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ, seeking and trying to attain the knowledge of the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Not only that, three things he mentions. The second thing is, so seeking the Qur'an and the Sunnah is your goal, is your aspiration. Second is, وَالْفَهْمُ عَنِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ, and you also want to understand it the way Allah and His Messenger intended it. Somebody comes up to you today and they say to you, Akhi, Allah told me not to pray. Allah told me not to pray. And what's your evidence? Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةِ. Huh? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, لَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةِ, don't come close to the prayer. And he stops there. I ask you, brothers, a question. Did Allah say that? Allah did say that. Is that what Allah and His Messenger intended? You see the difference now. What you said to me is what Allah said. Is that what Allah intended? No, He didn't intend that. Muradillah, and the murad of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, doesn't just mean when you transmit the wordings and the letters. It means that you understand it how Allah and His Messenger understood it. This is where usul al-fiqh comes into place. This is where you say to him, read the verse and finish it. Then when he finishes it, this is when you say to him, this is what Allah intended. يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةُ وَأَنْتُمْ سُكَارَىٰ. Don't come close to prayer whilst you're in a state of what? Intoxication. Ah, that's what the Sharia, that's what Allah and His Messenger intended. Are you with me, brothers? But the first thing that you want to attain is to, first of all, the Quran and the Sunnah is what you want to gain. The second thing is what you want to do is what? You want to understand what Allah and His Messenger intended by this. Many people today, they learn furu' al-masail. They'll tell you different aqwal. This mas'ala, ورد فيه ثلاثة أقوال. أما وردت فيه عشرون قولا. Oh, he'll tell you aqwal. This qawl said Abu Thawr, Layth, Sufyan ibn Uyayna, Ahmed said this, Imam this and Imam this said this. Kullu wahidin, this is what they said. He stops there. This is madhmum. This is blameworthy. This is not praiseworthy characteristics. Why? Jam'u al-aqwal is not what your aspiration as a student of knowledge should be. Bringing all of those aqwal together. Okay, who's right now? You don't know which one's right. So what would it benefit you bring all of the qawl together? The aspiration of a student of knowledge is what? Is the Quran and the Sunnah, that's your goal. If you do the jam'a of the aqwal of the ulama, and then you understand which of them is right, that's praiseworthy. You use it as a stepping stone to understand the Quran and the Sunnah, that's praiseworthy. There's nothing wrong with that. But to just bring all of the aqwal together, and to keep all the aqwal, and to have that with you, this is no benefit. It gets even worse if the person, all he does is he gathers aqwal which are shad. It gets even worse now. He takes views that are strange. That somebody might have said it, but it's a strange opinion. He takes those opinions on board and he makes it into a madhab. That person, فَقَدْ جَمَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ الشَّرُّ كُلُّ. All of evil is combined in that person. So what we need to know is, as a student of knowledge, you're not enslaved to memorize the statements of people. Your job as a Muslim, as a believer, as a student of knowledge is what? Al-Quran was Sunnah. That's what you're enslaved to come with and to understand. Now.
وقد كان هذا هو علم السلف عليهم رحمة الله ثم كثر كلام بعدهم فيما لا ينفع فالعلم في السلف أكثر والكلام في من بعدهم أكثر.
The author now then says, that's how the Salaf were like. They used to strive hard to memorize the Quran and the Sunnah. That was their goal. That was their ultimate drive. That's what they strive to. Their job, they didn't, Salaf or هذه الأمة, didn't waste their time memorizing aqwal all day. And then always reconciling between the aqwal of men. They weren't like that. Somebody is reconciling between the qawl al-qadim and the qawl al-jadid of the madhab al-shafi'iyya. Huh? That same individual can't reconcile between two ayat and two hadiths. This is incorrect. This is a himmah that's low. That's his aspiration that is low. وَلِذَلِكَ the Salaf, they didn't do that. They made sure they went directly to what? That they went directly towards the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Now, what I want you to understand is that if you are looking at the statement of the scholars to use it as a stepping stone for the Qur'an and the Sunnah, then this is praiseworthy. There's nothing wrong with this. But what I'm saying is that when you hold yourself on the statements of the scholars faqat, and you stop there, you don't go further. You pause there. You make that your ultimate goal. To know the qawl of Ahmed in this mas'ala, the qawl of Abu Thawr in this mas'ala, and the qawl of the ulama in this particular issue. You don't want to know why and how they got to this ruling. You don't want to ever know. And if somebody tries to find out, you rebuke them and say, what are you doing? Man, Ahmed said it, khalas. Why are you looking more into it? This is bad. And that's why knowledge became increased in number, in volumes. Books have become, people are talking about things that haven't happened and they're leaving off things that happened. Fardan wa taqdeeran, all they were in that. If this happens, ya akhi, let's talk about what's happening right now, okay? In Masail Fiqh, let's talk about things that are happening right now. People are talking about masail which haven't taken place and they're writing so much volumes on that, and the things that are actually happening are being, a blind eye is being turned towards it, or what's being said about it is very little. The Salaf never did that. When something popped up, they responded to it and they waited for its time to come. And that's what the author says, وَقَدْ كَانَ هَذَا هُوَ عِلْمُ السَّلَفِ. The ilm of the Salaf was like that. عَلَيْهِمْ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ كَثُرَ الْكَلَامُ بَعْدَهُمْ فِي مَا لَا يَنْفَعُ. The speech increased after them in that which wasn't beneficial. As they said, الْعِلْمُ نُقْطَةُ كَثَّرَهَا الْجُهَالُ. Knowledge used to be a dot. The ignorant people came and they made it so much dots. They asked too much questions, unnecessary speech. They didn't understand. The Salaf would speak sometimes. And when they spoke, they would use a very small sentence. The people that they're talking to are ulama and strong students of knowledge. So they understood straight away what he meant. Now if you say something, you have to explain your kalam in so many different angles, come from this angle. Finally the person will say to you, I now get what you mean. That's how jahl has become so much now. The person, everything's gone over their head. What do you mean by this? What do you mean? But remember, when they spoke, they were speaking to a people who, when the words were said to them, they didn't need sharah. They already had the background knowledge. They were intact. They were built. So they could just say a very summarized statement, and that's it. They understood it. وَلِذَٰلِكَ The more a person connects himself to the Salaf and their statements, the more his kalam becomes summarized. And the more the person reads the mutaakhirin, the late people, scholars, the more he's going to talk too much. Their kalam was very little, small. That's why Ibn Rajab authored a book on this issue. He called it Fadl ilm al-Salafi ala ilm al-Khalaf. The virtue of the knowledge of the pious predecessors over the later generation. ثُمَّ كَثُرَ الْكَلَامُ بَعَدَهُمْ فِي مَا لَا يَنْفَعُ Look at Ali ibn Abi Talib and the Khawarij, they said about him, حَكَّمَ الرِّجَالَ وَلَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ That he judged on people, and he didn't judge by what Allah sent down. Look how fast Ali responded to this. What did he say? كَلِمَةُ حَقٍّ أُرِيدَ بِهَا بَاطِلٌ خلاص. The kalima is haq, the intent behind it is evil. خلاص. He left it there. He didn't do what? Did they say? شَرَحْ خُطْبَةُ الْجُمْعَةِ 45 minutes of khutbah. Look at even the Prophet ﷺ's statement. What did he say? That a khatib who speaks for so long and his khutbah is long. The Prophet says this shows that his fiqh is very little. A khatib needs to come to the khutbah and give a khutbah of 15 to 20 minutes. A bullet point everything. Adilla. A little statement, delil. A little statement, delil. A little statement, delil. A little statement, delil. And leave it. And let the people go. And they understood each point that he was saying. Yeah. This khatib that he's talking, is his topic about istighfar? You don't know. Is it about tawbah? You don't know. Is it what you call about Jannah and Nar? He goes into everything. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? Utitu jawami al-kalim. I was given a summarized speech. And the scholars, they said, as much as you are close to the Mishkat al-Nubuwah, as much as you are close to the Prophet and you study his hadith and you read Kutub al-Hadith, the more your speech becomes very summarized. And you touch on things quickly. Now.
قال حماد بن زيد قلت لأيوب السختياني العلم اليوم أكثر أو فيما تقدم فقال الكلام اليوم أكثر والعلم فيما تقدم أكثر
The author رحمه الله then he brings the kalam of who? حماد بن زيد His name is Abu Ismail Hamad ibn Zayd ibn Dirham He died when the year was 179 Hijriya He took knowledge from Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani And he also took knowledge from Thabit al-Bunani and Asam and sorry, Asim ibn Abi Najud. You guys know Asim, right? Yeah? You guys know Asim? Huh? No? Who's Asim? Yeah. The Imam, Ilm al-Qira'at. Asim al-Nafi', right? He took knowledge from him. What did he take from him? الحروف في القراءات يتوق قراءات فهم This is Hamad ibn Zayd He's an imam in علم الحديث And he went to Asim ibn Abi Najud And he took from him What did he take from him? قراءات That's how they were before They were متفننين They will study every field of the religion He also took from Sufyan al-Thawri And Abdullah ibn Mubarak And Sufyan ibn Uyayn And others So they took from him Sufyan al-Thawri Abdullah ibn Mubarak And ibn Uyayn took from him They took from who? Hamad ibn Zayd. They were his students. ولذلك Abdullah ibn Mubarak, he said about Hamad ibn Zayd, he said, أيها الطالب علما ائت حماد ابن زيد فاستفد حلما وعلما ثم قيده بقيد ودع البدعة من آثار عمرو بن عبيدي He said. Abdullah ibn Mubarak said to the students of his time, أيها الطالب, O student of knowledge, أيها الطالب علما أو you who seeking knowledge, student of knowledge ائت حماد بن زيد go to حماد بن زيد فاستفد benefit from him حلما forbearance how he was a person who can endure hardship take that from him learn that from him وعلما and take knowledge from him ثم قيده بقيد and seal that knowledge and hold it down by writing it. Ya ikhwah, some people they come here, just listen all day. And then later he puts his bag on and he walks off. What did the poet say? Al-ilmu saydun wal-kitabatu qayduhu. Knowledge is what? Is like hunting. Knowledge is like hunting. وَالْكِتَابَةُ قَيْدُهُ. And the rope, that when you're hunting a deer, you use a rope to grab it, right? Or whatever you use something to grab it with. The thing that you're grabbing it with is the writing for knowledge. قَيِّدْ سُيُودَكَ بِالْحِبَالِ الْوَاثِقِ. When you're making sure that you're going to get that deer, what are you going to do? You're going to make sure that the rope is strong and it's tough. You're going to make sure you get it in sharply and everything and accurately at the right time. You're not going to miss it. Huh? Knowledge is like that. As it comes out of the person's mouth, it's going to run away from you. It's like that deer that's going to run. The way to grab it is with writing it down straight away. Then the poet said, فَمِنَ الْحَمَاقَةِ أَن تَصِيدَ غَزَالَةً. It is dimwittedness, stupidity, that you hunt a deer, وَتَتْرُكْهَا, and then you leave it بَيْنَ الْخَلَائِقِ طَالِقَ, and then you leave it amongst the people to just go. You hunted it, you grabbed it, you brought it, and then you let it go. You came here, you listened, you put all the effort in, but you're not grabbing the deer, you're not holding it down. So that's why he said, go to Hamad ibn Zayd, فَاسْتَفِدْ عِلْمًا وَحِلْمًا, benefit knowledge from him and forbearance. ثُمَّ قَيِّدْهُ بِقَيِّدٍ, and write his information that he's going to give you. And then he goes on to say, وَدَعِ الْبِدْعَةِ, leave of innovation, O young student of knowledge. مِنْ آثَارِ عَمْرُ بْنُ عُبَيْدٍ, stay away from Amr ibn Ubayd, the Mu'tazili, and his statements, stay away from that. The Salaf, they would advise the students to go somewhere, and they would advise them to be there. And they'll also warn against a particular person by name. That was this tariqah. Be careful, don't. This person's going to misguide you. Stay away from them. هذا من النصحة في دين الله. It's sincere advice. Stay away from them. So Hamad ibn Zayd is somebody Abdullah ibn Mubarak said that about. قُلْتُ, I said, لِأَيُّوبَ السَّخْتِيَانِ. Hamad ibn Zayd said, I said to my teacher, Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, I said to him, Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, his name is Ayyub ibn Abi Tamimah al-Sakhtiyani. He died a year when it was 131 Hijriya. He died a year when it was 131 Hijriya. وَلِذَلِكَ, one of the powerful things that are transmitted from, are you with me, brothers? There's kalam, there's hikam that was transmitted from him. Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, rahimahullahu ta'ala. And from the statements that were transmitted from him was what? Another statement that Hamad ibn Zayd said, I heard a person say to Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani one day, مَا لَكَ لَا تَنْظُرُ فِي هَذَا. Why is it that you don't look into this matter? يعني علم الكلام أما الرأي. Why don't you look into علم الكلام? Why don't you look into philosophy and stuff like that? Why don't you give a little look to it? And then he responded quickly and fast. And look how short their statement was. He said, قِيلَ لِلْحِمَارِ, it was said to the donkey. It was said to the donkey, أَلَا تَجْتَرُّ. It was said to the donkey, why don't you do what the camel does? Because the camel, what it does is that it brings out what it ate, it brings it to its mouth and it starts chewing it. And then it takes it back, it brings it out again, and he does that all the time. They said to the donkey, hey donkey, why don't you, it's an Arab proverb, why don't you do what the donkey does? It saves us a lot. For a whole month, the donkey doesn't need to eat, drink, it can live. It keeps bringing back what he ate with his stomach. Have you guys seen the camel? It was chewing. Camel is always chewing. His stomach, I think it's about, some stomach is divided to six or something. He puts one, stores it. He brings out another one. نعم والله أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت. This animal is a machine. It's made for the desert. You know his eyelashes, the camel. His sunglasses stop the sand from coming to his eyes, entering his eyes. It's the only animal that could walk with his eyes open through the what do you call it? What's it called? When there's a sandstorm. This animal is something else. His lips are made for particularly, his teeth, everything. His legs, his hooves, it's all made in a way. Subhanallah. So a donkey was said to him, why don't you do what the camel does? Bring it out, keep using it. And then he said, قَالَ أَكْرَهُ مَضْضَعَ قَالَ أَكْرَهُ I dislike مَضْغَ الْبَاطِلِ I hate this false chewing. It's all day chewing falsehood. Something you already finished that you've got done with. Bringing it back all day, I hate that. It's مَضْغَ الْبَاطِلِ So what Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani is trying to take from this, what Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani is trying to take from this is what? I don't like chewing on batil. Ilm al-Kalam is batil, I don't want to chew on it. That's how they used to see it. Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, rahimahullah, Hamad ibn Zayd asked him, he said to him, al-ilmu al-yawma aktharu aw fima taqaddam. Knowledge today is more. Or is it more before? Is knowledge more today or is knowledge more before? This is the question that he asked Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, Hamad ibn Zayd asked. Al-ilmu al-yawma aktharu. Knowledge today is more or is it more before? And then he said, "Al-kalamu al-yawma aktharu." Today, speech and talking is more. Wal-ilmu fi ma taqaddama aktharu. But before, knowledge was more. They spoke little. And this is something you have to understand today. People think the one who can talk too much and the one who can say a lot is the most knowledgeable one, right? Yeah? Are you with me, brothers? There were some scholars, imams, they weren't good talkers. They couldn't even say what they wanted to say properly. They were a'imma kibar. When they talk, they're not appealing to you. When they say something, you're just like, what are you talking about? Like in the ilm that this person has in him is profound. When he writes, when he authors, when he puts things together, it's amazing. But when you listen to him, where are you going with this? What are you saying? I don't get what you're trying to say. Are you with me, brothers? He doesn't speak a lot. One sentence, one line of speech, and he leaves it. A lot of the times you think to yourself, you will think to yourself, that because he can't speak and he can't articulate himself, and he can't go into tafasir, and he doesn't use fancy terms, that this person is what? He is not a person of knowledge. You think so. And that's not the case. Salafu hadhi al-ummah, they spoke little, very, very little. You come to a person asks you a question today, you answer it very quick. They want you to go into tafasil and istikhraj and dala and you know this and that and that and that and that. Sah? That doesn't necessarily mean that you're knowledgeable if you can do that. Some people are only what? مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُوهَا كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُوا أَسْفَارًا They just have information. Is Google knowledgeable? No, it's not knowledgeable. It just holds so much information. It's just holding information. A lot of people are just holding information. Are they people of knowledge? No. They're not people of knowledge. They just have a lot of information in their head. Are you with me? So sometimes, and I've realized one thing personally, some of the ulama, when you meet them, when they're answering the question, they don't have a method to gradually get you to the conclusion that they have reached. They just give you the conclusion. And that puts you upon hayra, confusion. You think he doesn't know what he's talking about. Are you with me? That's why the Salaf were like that, very short in their speech. They won't talk about the answer from here. They'll do it from there, and they'll leave it there. Years in your life, when you grow up, you'll realize, wow. Yeah, sometimes I used to listen to Sheikh Al-Albani being asked questions, and I feel like, subhanAllah, Sheikh didn't even answer the question. Are you with me? In Mecca, in Taraweeh, Ramadan, when it finished, I used to always, after Taraweeh finishes, Sheikh Salih Al-Luhaydan in the Haram, after Taraweeh, he sits for fatwa. When people pray Isha, Taraweeh, everything, right in front of the Kaaba. They give him a seat and he answers questions. So he does maybe 10, 15, 20 minutes reminder first, and then he answers questions. Sometimes a question will be asked and it's so quick in the answer he gives. He doesn't break it down, he doesn't go in. As you grow and you seek more knowledge in your life, you realize some of the answers that he gave was exactly the answer that you would give if you were asked that same question. That's how it is when it comes to knowing those who were. Layth ibn Sa'd, it was said about him, was very little in speech, in the sense where he wasn't. Some of the scholars, they said Layth ibn Sa'd was more knowledgeable than Imam Shafi'i. But the only problem that they said he had was he wasn't an individual who could articulate his information properly. And due to that, and of course other factors, which he didn't have students to carry on his madhab, to spread his methodology and his belief and his works. We'll conclude there, inshallah ta'ala, and we will carry on the kitab, ثلاثة الأصول.